Swamin namaste nataloka bandho karunya sindho patitam bhavabdhau mudharatmiya kataksha drishtya rijvyati karunya sudhabhivrishtya swamin namaste swamin namaste swamin namaste swamin namaste yat kirtanam yat smaranam yadikshanam yad vandanam yad shravanam yad arhanam lokasya sadyo vidhunoti kalmasham tasmai subhadra shravase namo namaha vichakshanaya charanopasadanat Sangam vyudasyo bhayato antaratmanah vindanti hi brahmagatim gataklamaha tasmai subhadra shravase namo namah tasmai subhadra shravase Namo Namaha Tasmai Subhadra Shravase Namo Namaha Jai Guru, Jai Guru, Jai Guru. So we are all ready to go to the bank of Ganges where Parikshit is sitting without food, without any water, and sitting in front of Shukadeva. Sitting in front of Shukadeva with hands folded, with tearful eyes, and drinking the nectar that is flowing from Shukadeva's mouth. What is he talking about? Shukadeva is talking about Sri Hari. And after some days, Parikshit, when he became very restless and he started asking, please tell me about Krishna. Now he has started talking about Krishna and we are listening to those stories. As I told you yesterday also, these are not stories. These are not only devotion which has been explained. This is supreme jnana, attaining which one can feel the presence of the Lord inside one's own heart, realize the Lord and realize the embrace that the Lord gives us always. Yesterday we saw that Krishna has grown up and from the very beginning of his birth, as Kamsa was trying to kill all the children, because Kamsa did not know where his enemy has got born. All his followers, the asuras, they were going from village to village, town to town, and killing children. Similarly, they were going to Gokula. And Krishna also had been attacked. So many times his life was threatened when he was just a child, a baby. Putana came and you know the story how Krishna killed Putana. After that, so many asuras had come, Shakatasura, Aghasura, Dhenukasura, Bakasura, and so many of them. But to the surprise of Nandagopa and other Gopas, to the surprise of everybody in Gokula, Krishna every time killed. Everybody thought that it is not Krishna who has killed. Maybe somehow the Asura has got killed. But as days were passing by, they were understanding that there is something in this boy. And that was something which Nanda Gopa alone knew. When Krishna's name ceremony was done by Gargacharya, Gargacharya had told Nanda Gopa that this boy of yours has some very, very significant qualities. He is Narayana himself, and he will be doing all for good to your community. Look after him well. He is same as Narayana in his prowess, in his qualities and characteristics. So Nanda Gopa, though he used to think this is my child, sometimes during those moments when an asura got killed by Krishna, he used to remember, oh, I was told like this. Maybe that is why. Other people in Gokula, they used to think, we worship Lord Narayana always, so Narayana has saved this child and killed the asura. Anyway, when all these things started happening quite frequently, all the elders of Vrajabhumi, they thought, better leave this place and go to some other place. And they decided to go to Vrindavana. They said that it's a very nice place to stay for all seasons. It has fields full of beautiful grass for our cattle. And there are lakes and river. There are mountains and hills. It's very nice to be there. So all of them shifted there. There, Krishna was growing up. From childhood, he attained boyhood. Then he attained Kaishora. All the children, all the gopas, they used to go with Krishna and Balarama. By that time, Krishna and Balarama had attained that age when they could also graze the cattle. So right in the morning, they will be going from this place to that place throughout the forest of Vrindavana. And how was Vrindavana like? Let us go to Vrindavana today. Many of us might have visited Vrindavana. Everybody knows by the very name of Vrindavan, we feel holy and pure. Today, along with Krishna and Balarama, let us see where is Vrindavan and where, how is Vrindavan? What was happening there? In Vrindavan, wherever Krishna went, every place got sanctified. It was full of lakes, calm lakes, and beautiful cool breeze used to blow over the lakes. The lakes were full of red lotuses. The forests were full of flowers. There would be fragrance blowing in the air. There were so many birds and animals and peacocks and whatnot. The peacocks used to coo as if welcoming Sri Krishna, as if honoring them, sorry. The kokilas used to coo as if welcoming Krishna, as if to tell him, please come here. The peacocks used to spread their peacock feathers and would dance around as if in honor of Lord Krishna. Wherever they went, the trees and plants full of flowers and fruits would bow down as if to offer the flowers at Krishna's feet and as if to offer the fruits in worship. Everywhere, wherever they went, everything became fortunate because it was as if Krishna was looking at them. The grass, even the blades of grass felt that we are fortunate because we are being trampled by Sri Krishna. The rivers, the lakes, the mountains, and every tree and branch of trees, everything felt that we are fortunate enough because Krishna is within us. And what was Krishna doing? What were the gopas doing? Early in the morning, they would go. Their mothers will dress them up with little food, which they would carry. Krishna will be playing his flute, which will simply enamor everybody, simply would melt everybody's heart. And they would be grazing the cattle and playing around. They will be going and playing as if they were little boys. sometimes wearing the masks of bulls and making sound as bulls. Sometimes they will be fighting in a mock fight, they will fight with each other. Sometimes they will hum as if the honey bees are humming. Sometimes they will be imitating the birds and the animals. This is what they were doing. And what was Krishna like? Krishna was like this. Vadha peedham natavara vapuhu karnayo karnikaram vibhradvasah kanaka kapisham vaijayanti chamalam randhran veno radhara sudhaya purayan gopavrindaihi vrindaranyam swapadaramanam pravishat geeta kirtihi vadha peedham natavara vapuhu karnayo karnikaram. He was beautiful to look at. You know, even now, when we look at a photo of Sri Krishna, who has painted it? Who has given that form? But something melts in the heart. He was beautiful to look at, and as if he was a super dancer. Natavara vapuhu karnayo karnikaram. He had earrings made of karnikara flower. Vibhradvasah kanaka kapisham vaijayanti chamalam. And his dress was yellow in color, having a golden radiance. And he was having a plume of peacock feather, as we all know. Vaijayanti chamalam. He had a vaijayanti mala on his neck. Randhran veno radhara sudhaya purayan gopa vrindaihi. What he would do while grazing the cattle? He will be playing his flute and filling the holes of the flute with his adhara sudha, with the nectar which comes out as a honey from his lips. And he would be going around with the gopas, his friends, who will be singing his glories. You know, who was he? He is the one who, hiding his real identity by the power of his own maya. Who is he? He is the Supreme Lord. He has taken incarnation. He has limited himself in the form of a little boy, in the form of a young boy, Krishna, who is going around with his friends and grazing cattle, playing the flute and making everybody mad after him. He has hidden his real identity by his own maya, and he has assumed the form, and he does the activities of a cowherd boy. He who is in reality the Supreme Divine, he lived as a rustic boy in that village. The very thought of that the infinite has come to us with a finite body. Oh dear devotees, we should feel blessed. We should feel fortunate. And who was he? He who has been realized by the yogis and jnanis as the Nirvishesha Brahmananda. The yogis and jnanis have been doing austerities and tapasya for ages and ages. And at one time they realize him as what? As the Satchidananda, at the Brahmic bliss. The devotees know him as God or Parameshwara. And those who are under the grip of his maya, they feel that he is a mere boy. But he played with the gopas just like a rustic boy, hiding his own identity. How can one describe the good fortune of the inhabitants of Braja? The fortune that they had. The Supreme Lord, hiding his own identity, was playing with them, sitting with them, eating with them, playing with them, and going to place from place to place in Vrindavan, delighting everybody's heart. How fortunate the gopas and gopis were. Just think of it. And the dust of his feet, the yogis even failed to attain. The one whose dust of the feet are not even attained by yogis for years and years, with that person who was hiding his real identity, the gopas and the gopis, they felt, they are my boy. He is a small boy, young Krishna, who is ours, our own. His excellences, his unparalleled excellences, were spreading everywhere. His beauty was spreading everywhere, not only in Vrindavan, Mathura, which was very near, it would spread there also. There all the Mathura Vasis became very, very fond of him, very attracted about him. They had not seen him, but they were hearing about him, his excellences, how he has killed many asuras, how he makes every gopa and gopi delighted, full of delight, that they do not remember anything. You know how the gopikas were? Yadohane abahanane mathanopalepa prenkhenkhanarbharuditokshana marjanadau gayanti jaina manurattat dhriyoshrukanthyo dhanyavrajastriya urukramachittayanah yadohane abahanane mathanopalepa prenkhenkhanarbharuditorjanamarjanadau gayanti jainamanurattadhiyoshrukanthyo dhanyavrajastriya urukramachittayanah. Nandagopa and his elderly friends, all of them would be talking about Krishna. The gopas, the small boys, they used to sing his songs while going with Krishna himself. And what were the gopika doing? Right from the morning, as soon as they will hear the cattle going past their houses, they will run, leaving everything, and stand at the door to look at him. When he came back with the cattle, then again they will go there and look at him, just to look at his face, the smiling face, and which always gave karuna, showered mercy and compassion, and which delighted them. This shloka says, yadohane abahanane. These gopikas, they did every household work, whether it was getting up in the morning, then sweeping the angan, or looking after the children, making them stop their crying, cradling them in the swings, cooking, making, boiling milk, making butter, anything that they had as household work, they were doing. But along with that, where was their mind? Their mind was on Krishna. Gayanti chaina manurakta dhiyo shrukanthyo. They used to do all the household work thinking about Krishna, and their eyes will be shedding with delight, and they will be thinking of all the excellences and the deeds and the exploits that he has done. Can we not be like this? What does this shloka say? We always feel we have lot of work. We cannot give 5 minutes to God, maximum half an hour, that too with lot of difficulty, because we are all in the household, we have to do lot of work, there is lot of responsibility and duties for us. So where is the time to think of God? Where is the time to sit in meditation? Where is the time to be chanting some stotras or reading some spiritual or devotional books? These lives of the gopis are showing us. They were doing everything that they had to do, but their mind was full of Krishna. The mind never fell back from that. So this is what we have to learn from that. So as like any other Mathura Vasi, Akrura also was hearing about Krishna. Krishna's prowess, Krishna's beauty, Krishna's deeds and excellences, and he being a devotee, he was getting more and more attracted to Krishna and growing more and more devotion to Krishna. He was so devoted that he lost all other interests. He only thought, this is my Lord, when will I see him? And now the chance has come. How the chance has come? Don't forget. Don't forget, where are we? We are sitting with Parikshit. And Shukadeva is telling the story of Akrura. Akrura is going to Vrindavan. We also are going to Vrindavan along with Akrura. Kamsa has called Akrura and holding his hand, he is saying, you are my best friend. Out of all the people in your clan, I don't find anybody who is more generous and humble. Please do this for me. Here is a chariot. Bring Balarama and Sri Krishna here. Because I have come to know from Narada now that Krishna will kill me. Before he kills, I want to bring him here and kill him. I will be arranging one Dhanuriyagya. And in the Shamiana, that pandal that I am going to put up, at the gate, I will keep Kuvalaya Pida, the elephant who is a picture of death. So when Krishna and Balarama enter that gate, Kuvalaya Pida will kill them. Suppose Kuvalaya Pida is not able to kill them, I have arranged for wrestling match. Chanura and Mushtika, they will definitely kill them. So please go bring them here in the name of this wrestling match. Tell them, I, the uncle, I have not seen them for a long time. I am eager to see them. And I have heard about their prowess, their strength. I want also to see how they are doing a wrestling match. Also, invite Nandagopa and others because we need a lot of milk and milk products in this yajna. So let them also come. Akrura heard everything. You know what he said? O king, you have had all plans ready with you. It is true that death is approaching you. Death is very near you. And to escape from death, you have made a plan. But keep your mind even-minded. We may always make plans, but there is a factor where divine intervention comes in. The divine may be thinking of something else. So whatever comes, please accept it. And saying that, he went home. And next day, he took the chariot and he is going where? To Vrindavan. I think, you know, when I first read this chapter, I was thrilled. I was having Roma Harshana because I was feeling this is how we should go and meet a Mahatma. How was he going? His whole mind was full of Krishna, whom he has not seen, he is going to meet, and who is Krishna, who is the incarnation of the Supreme Lord. And that is what a Mahatma is. When we go to meet a Mahatma, our feelings and our mind should be like this. So he goes, he's saying, you know what he's saying? Kim maya charitam bhadram, kim taptam paramam tapah, kim vathapyarhate dattam, yadraksham yadyakeshavam, mamaitad durlabham manye, uttama shloka darshanam, vishayatmano yatha brahma kirtanam, shudra janmanaha, kim maya charitam bhadram. I must have done something very, very noble. I must have done. Otherwise, how is it that Kamsa has chosen me to bring Krishna and I'll be seeing him actually? Kim maya charitam bhadram, kim taptam paramam tapah. I also must have done lot of austerity. Kim vathapyarhate dattam yadraksham yadyakeshamam. I must have given lot of charity also. I must have given dana. So I must have done something good. I must have also given dana and I must have done some austerities, tapasya. Mamaitad durlabham manye uttama shloka darshanam vishayatmano yatha brahma kirtanam shudra janmanah. As it is difficult for shudras in olden days, shudras and women were barred from uttering Vedas. It is not like that now. So it says that as it is difficult for the shudras to utter the name of Brahma or Vedas, chanting of Vedas were difficult. Similarly, for a worldly person, it is very, very rare to have the darshan of Uttama Shloka, the Supreme Lord. It is very rare. We feel we are devotees. We want to have darshan. We go to the temple and have darshan of what? An idol, which is not able to talk to us, which is not able to guide us, which is not able to do anything. But still we go there and do pranam. What it is then to be actually having the darshan of the Lord and feel Him, realize Him. Maivam mamadhamasyapi syadevachyuta darshanam hriyamanah kala nadya kvachit tarati kashchana. Says that if there is grace of God, even though it is difficult, it becomes possible. It becomes possible for some people to have what they wish, if God wishes it. Mama adya mangalam nashtam phalavam chaiva me bhavah yannamasye bhagavato yogidhyayangri pankajam. Mama adya mangalam nashtam phalavam chaiva me bhavah yannamasye bhagavato yogidhyayangri pankajam. I think, I'm very sure, adya mama amangalam nashtam. All my amangala, my impurities have become completely destroyed today. Because today I am going to see Krishna. I have become eligible and deserving to have the darshan of Krishna. All my amangala must have got destroyed. Phalavam shaiva me bhavah. And my birth in this life, in this world, I think, I feel fulfilled that I have taken birth. When you feel like this, you know, when you have a connection, an association with a holy person, we must feel like this. Shankaracharya says, Durlabham trayamevaitad devanugraha hetukam manushyatvam mumukshutvam Mahapurusha samshrayaha. Three things are rare. What is one? One is manushyatvam, to have a human birth. Then mokshutvam. We may be having a human birth, but we do not have the yearning to have the darshan of God or yearning to be liberated in life. Even if we have both, the third rare thing also must be ours. That is Mahapurusha samshrayaha. We must be associated closely with a Mahapurusha, a Mahatma. So he's saying that phalavams chaiva me bhavaha. My birth in this world, I feel, has been completely worthwhile and fulfilling. Yan namasye bhagavato yogidhyayangri pankajam. All the yogis, they are constantly engaged in tapasya, in dhyana, to attain that holy feat. And they are not attaining it. It takes a long time for them. But now I am going to do pranam at those holy feet when I see those holy feet. Kamso vatadya kritametyanugraham drakshengri padmam prahito munaharehe Kritavatarasya duratyayam tamaha purvetaran yannakhamandalatvisha. Kamsa, who is not at all generous and kind, he has done a very good thing for me, because he is sending me to bring Krishna. I am so very grateful to him, and by going I will be meeting him. I will be doing pranam to his feet, the feet, the light of the toenails of which takes away the ignorance from the hearts of all those sadhakas who are pursuing sadhana. Do you understand? I am going to do pranam to those feet, the light from the toenails of whose feet it destroys the ignorance, the darkness of ignorance from the heart of the devotees who are in ignorance. And all the ignorance from my heart also be completely gone. Yadarchitam brahma bhavadhi visurai shriya cha devya munibhissa satvatai gocharaya gocharanayanucharaischaradvane yad gopikanam kuchakunkumankitam yadarchitam brahma bhavadhi visurai shriya cha devya munibhissa satvatai gocharayanaanucharaischaradvane yad gopikanam kuchakunkumankitam. These are the feet. See, he is telling himself. What is he doing? He is going to Vrindavana. How? He is on the ratha. He is in the chariot. And these are the reveries. He is thinking himself. He is imagining. He is imagining Sri Krishna. And he is thinking that when I go, I will be doing pranam to him. To those feet which the yogis try to attain, I will be doing pranam. Kamsa, who is not at all kind, has sent me for this mission. I have become deserving. I did not expect it. So I am so fortunate. These are the feet which Brahma worships, Maheshwara worships, and all the devatas worship. These feet which they all worship, today I have the fortune of holding them. Dear devotees, think like this. Think like this. At least mentally let us hold those feet and get the touch of those holy feet. And Sri Lakshmi Devi, she also worships those feet. All the devatas, all the munis, all the devotees, they are worshipping that feet which is now roaming about in Vrindavan. Drakshyami nunam sukapola nasikam. Now he is thinking, I will reach there, I will see him. He is so beautiful to look at. Drakshyami nunam sukapola nasikam. He who has a broad forehead, who has high nose and cheek, smitavalokarunakanjalochanam, and whose face is always smiling. He is spreading compassion, mercy and delight to the devotees who come near him, who think about him, who remember him. Kanjalochanam, and his eyes are like red lotuses. Such a beautiful face I'll be able to see today. And mukham mukundasya gudalakavritam pradakshinam me pracharanti vai mrigaha drakshyami nunam sukapola nasikam smitavalokaruna kanjalochanam mukham mukundasya gudalakavritam. And his face, which has that high nose and high cheek and the beautiful eyes, which is like a lotus, and who is constantly showering delight and compassion to us, the devotees, that face has the curly locks, which is beautifying the face. From his head, curly locks are beautifying his face. I will be seeing him today. I am understanding, I am very sure, because all these deer, they are roaming about me. They are roaming around me. Seeing that, I am understanding something very good is going to happen to me today. and this must be that. I think I'm going. He will be definitely there. I'll be able to see him. Prasada bhimukham shashvan prasanna vadanekshanam sunasam subhruvam charu kapolam surasundaram prasada bhimukham shashvan prasanna vadanekshanam sunasam subhruvam charu kapolam surasundaram. Describing Sri Krishna, he is Akrura is thinking of Krishna, that his face is like this, his nose is like this, his hair is like this, and his eyes are like this. Once when devotees start thinking like this, wholesomely, wholeheartedly, to the exclusion of everything else, then they get that bliss which never gets lost. Everlasting bliss they get. So he is also thinking like that. Apyadya vishor manujatva meyusho bharavataraya bhuvo nijachaya lavanya dhamno bhavito palambhanam mahyam nanasyat phalamanjasadrishah. Apyadya vishnor manujatva meyusho bharavataraya bhuvo nijechaya lavanya dhamno bhavito palambhanam mahyam nanasyat phalamanjasadrishah. He's thinking that today I will see him, that Vishnu, the incarnation of Vishnu, Sri Krishna, who by his own will has come down to the earth. He who is birthless, who is infinite, eternal, who is unlimited, he has taken birth as a limited boy, the Krishna. And why he has taken that birth? Because the earth is full of the asuras and the rakshasas, adharma. He has come down as Krishna to remove adharma from this earth and make dharma victorious. Nijechaya, with his own will he has come down. I'll be able to see him today. He is Lavanya Dhamnaha. He is the center of abounding beauty. When I see him, will not my eyes become fulfilled with that vision? Will I still be hankering after other things which I always want to see? Devotees, think about this sentence. Throughout the day, from the morning till night, we are only looking at outside objects, thinking that from outside objects alone we will get happiness. We are always looking here and there. He is saying, I also do like that. But after I have seen him, will not my eyes become fulfilled? And will I still be wanting to see anything else? I should not. Yasya khilami bahabhi sumangalaihi vacho vimishra gunakarma janmabhihi prananti shumbhanti punanti vai jagat yastad viraktaha shavashobhanamataha. Yasya khilami bahabhi sumangalaihi vacho vimishra guna karma janma bhihi prananti shumbhanti punanti vai jagat yastad virakta shavashobhanamata. You know, I wish I could tell you every word, the meaning of every word which inspires. Beautiful word. From any shloka you cannot reduce or change the words. These are the soul cry of the sages of ancient ages, who their feelings and their sentiments and their devotion, everything they have written in these shlokas, which we cannot change at all. All our scriptures have been handed down from guru to shishya, guru to shishya, in exactly the same manner. Many other books we may have to edit, these books cannot be edited. What is he saying? All the words and the compositions were devoted to describe the sanctifying and auspicious excellences and the sportive deeds of Sri Krishna. They, when we read them, prananti, it energizes us. Shumbhanti, it beautifies us. Punanti, it purifies us. When we read about him, it should purify us. It should energize us. It should beautify us. That is why I feel from my own experience that we should get identified with each character. When we are reading about Krishna, we should be Krishna himself. When we are reading about the gopas and gopikas, we should be them. We should be exactly the characters, and then only we can understand what has been written here. Prananti shumbhanti punanti vai jagat yastad virakta shavashobhanamataha. Any composition, any description which does not have the description of Lord Krishna, does not tell anything about Lord Krishna, that is like decorating a shava, decorating a corpse. Bhagavata is saying this. That is, any composition which has Krishna's story, Krishna's exploits, which are sanctifying, which are purifying, and which energizes us, beautifies us, purifies us, those alone are great. Other things only excites us. Other things only excites us, takes our mind to unnecessary things and puts us and drowns us in fear and tension and anxiety. So he says, Shavashobhanamataha, those descriptions or compositions which do not have Krishna's words, do not have anything to tell about Krishna, they are like shava. They are like corpses which have been decorated. Bharav param patta kirita jushtam apyuttamangam na namen mukundam shavau karau no kuruta sapariyam harer lasat kanchana kankanau va. Bharav param patta kirita jushtam apyuttamangam na namen mukundam. Uttamangam is the head. You may be having a very good crown made of very costly silk and studded with diamonds and costlier jewels. Still, that crown, which is so costly, will become a bhara for you. Will become a bhara for you. That is, it will become a burden for you if that head which is wearing that crown does not bend down in humility and does not do pranam to Lord Krishna. Shavau karau no kuruta sapariyam harer lasat kanchana kankanau va. Similarly, if the two hands, they may be having many, many bangles, costly bangles, diamond bangles, those hands will be just like the hands of a corpse if those two do not join and do pranam to Lord Mukunda. Mrishagirasta hyasati rasatkatha nakathyate ad bhagavan adhokshajaha tadeva satyam taduhaiva mangalam tadeva punyam bhagavad gunodayam tadeva ramyam ruchiram navam navam tadeva shashvan manaso mahotsavam tadeva shokarnava shoshanam rinam yaduttama shloka yashonugiyate. Just like Akrura is thinking that any composition which does not talk about Sri Krishna is useless, it is not at all meaningful. Similarly, it says that alone is satyam, that alone is true, that alone is auspiciousness, and that alone is punya, which talks about Lord Krishna. That alone gives us Shashvat Mahotsavam, that is a festivity which is eternal. All the festivities, other festivities, they perish, they never remain. So like that, he was going on thinking. He was going on thinking. And he was saying, he has now completely got absorbed in Krishna's Rupa. He's thinking of Krishna and he's thinking, when I see him, what will I do now? Tam tvadyanunam mahatam gatim gurum trailokya kantam drishiman mahotsavam rupam dadhanam shriyaipsitaspadam drakshye mamasan nushasa sudarshanaha. He says, right from morning today, I'm having very auspicious signs. I'm seeing auspicious sights. So I'm understanding this today is very auspicious for me. Tam tvadyanunam mahatam gatim gurum. I'll be seeing him. Who is he? Trailokya kantam. He is mahatam gatim gurum. For all the holy people, he is the refuge. He is the guru. All the sages and saints, for them, he is the guru. He is the refuge. Trailokya kantam. He is the beautiful one in the whole of three worlds. The most beautiful one. Drishiman mahotsavam. Just mark this word. Drishiman mahotsavam. He is the one who is worthy of seeing for those who have eyes to see. Those who have eyes to see, he is the only one who is the worth, who is worthy of being seen. Are you understanding? Jinke paas aankh hai, sirf wahi hai jo jinko hum dekhein. Aur sab kuch dekhne se hamare man mein bhay hota hai. Sukh bhi hota hai, anand bhi hota hai, uske saath saath usko khone ka dar laga rehta hai. Kya bol rahe hain? Drishiman mahotsavam. He is festivity, eternal festivity to everybody. Whatever we see, we may be in a festival, we may be in big gatherings, even this gathering where Pujya Swamiji has come, the new center has come up, all of us are coming every day with lot of excitement, devotion and delight. All this after Swamiji leaves, that festival feeling will not be there. So every festival is perishable. Only the Lord, the Supreme Lord, who can give Shashvata Mahotsavam to people. He is the one who gives us Mahotsava, which is eternal. So it says, Drishiman Mahotsavam. If we have eyes, we should only think of him. We should only contemplate on him. Wherever we see, we should see Krishna. In everybody, every human being, everything that is in this world, everything should become God and the Supreme Lord. Rupam dadhanam shriya ipsitaspadam drakshye mamasan nushasa sudarshanaha. He is the one whom Lakshmi Devi also always is propitiating to be with him. Now, he's thinking, I will see him. He looks like this. I will feel so very devotion, so much of devotion I feel in my heart. And he's this one who can give me festivity, eternal festivity. And when I see him, what should I do? What should I do? He's thinking. Athavarudha sapadishayorathat pradhana pumsos charanam Swalabdhaye dhyadhritam yogibhirapyaham dhruvam namasyabhyam jasakhinvanaukasaha. If we were to see God, what we will do? I think the first thing that we do is do pranam. So he says, as soon as I see him, I will get down from my ratha, my chariot, and I will fall at his feet. He is the pradhana purusha. And He is the one with the yogis, which yogis always contemplate upon. Seeing those holy lotus feet, I cannot but fall down at his feet and do pranam. Apyanghrimule. I would like you to think this one shloka. Think that you have got down from the ratha, you have touched his feet, and you are lying at his feet. Apyanghrimule patitasya me vibhu shirasya dhasya nijahasta pankajam dhyadhritam dattabhayam kalabhujangaram hasa prodvejitanam sharanaishinam ninam. When we fall down at his holy feet, what will the Lord do? I would like to get his hand on my head. The Lord should pick me up with his hand and place his hands on my head. Dattabhayam kalabhujangaram hasa. Because those are the hands which gives us abhaya. Every one of us, we need abhaya. We are fearful in this world. Small fear and big fears. We are always fearful. We are always anxious. We need abhaya from the Lord. So he says, when I fall down, apyanghrimule patitasya me, I have fallen down. My Lord will lift me up and he will put his hands on my head. Dear devotees, the first time I read this, I wept. I could feel those hands on my head. I felt that he has taken away all my fear. He has accepted me. He has taken me as his child and taken me up, put his hands on my head and saying, don't be afraid, there is no fear. I am with you. All people who propitiate him, who take refuge in his holy feet, they become fearless because he can give that abhaya. Virachita bhayam vrishnidhuryate charanamiyusham samsriter bhayat karasaroruham kantakamadam shirasi dehinah shrikaragraham virachita bhayam vrishnidhuryate charanamiyusham samsriter bhayat karasaroruham kantakamadam shirasi dehinah shrikaragraham. These are told by the gopis to Sri Krishna, that O Lord, O delighter of our hearts, place your calm hands on my head, on our heads, the hands which give fearlessness to everybody, the hands which can take away the worldliness from every one of us, the hands which give boons to the devotees when they propitiate you. Please put those hands on our head. We have to feel it. It is not listening. It is not reading. One has to feel it. One has to understand it. You may read only one shloka a day, but understand, assimilate and live. That is what we should do. Virachita bhayam vrishnidhuryate charanamiyusham samsriter bhayat karasaroruham kantakamadam shirasi dehinah shrikaragraham. You please put your hands on my head, O Lord. You know, I think we have come all the way when Parikshit had asked a question. What did he ask? yat shrotavyam atho japyam yat smartavyam nibhiprabho. He said, what should I hear? What should I chant? What is my duty? What should I remember? And what worship I should do? And Shukadeva told right in the beginning that worship Lord Hari. If you want fearlessness, worship Lord Hari. He is the one smartavyaha, shrotavyaha, kirtitavyaha. He is the one about whom we should hear, about whom we should contemplate upon, and whose songs we should sing. This is what we should do. We have come to Akrura. We are going to Vrindavana with him. But we should preserve this, the feelings of Akrura. What he felt, how he was thinking, how he was imagining. And in doing so, what was he doing actually? He was getting immersed in the Lord, getting merged into the Lord. Taila dharavat, his mind had become just like oil. If we pour oil, oil just keeps on flowing without any break. His mind had become like this. We should also do. Tava kathamritam tapta jivanam kavibhiriditam kalmashapaham shravanamangalam shrimadatatam bhuvigrinantite bhuridajana tava kathamritam tapta jivanam kavibhiriditam kalmashapaham shravanamangalam shrimadatatam bhuvigrinantite bhuridajana. It says, O Lord, when we hear about you, we get purified. Tava kathamritam tapta jivanam. Our lives are scorched. So many kinds of sufferings are there. It is as if remaining scorched by fire, as if there is a big storm making us uprooted, as if we are getting drowned in water. So it says, tava kathamritam tapta jivanam. The kathamritam, if we listen to your kathamrita, the tapta jivanam, the scorched life that we have, you bring in purity and holiness to that. You make it all cool. Kabhibhiriritam kalmashapaham. All our sins will be purified. Shravanamangalam shrimadatatam bhuvigrinantite bhuridajana. They are the real gift makers. They are the ones who give us the real gifts. Who are the ones who constantly sing your name, tell us your stories, and make our mind uplifted? Mano nayana vardhanam. Our mind and our eyes, they get uplifted. So he says now, namayupaishyatyati aribuddhi machyutah kamsasya dutah prahitopi vishvadrik yontarvahischetasa etadihitam kshetrajya ikshatyamalena chakshusha. He says, now he is feeling worried. I'll be falling at his feet. I want his hand on my head. But suppose, hearing that Kamsa has sent me, he doesn't accept me, he doesn't lift me up, what will happen? Then he is consoling himself, saying that no, he is the Lord, he is the indweller, and he knows what is going on in the mind of everybody. He will very well know that though Kamsa has sent me, I am a real devotee of his. So I have come with devotion. Though Kamsa has sent me, I am very sure that Kamsa will not be able to kill him, and Kamsa will be killed in his hands. Apyagnghrimule vahitam kritanjalim mamikshita sasmita madraya disha sapadya padvasta samasta kilvisho bodhamudam vita vishanka urjitam apyangrimule vahitam kritanjalim mamikshita sasmita madraya disha. So he had prostrated, he has got the hands of the Lord on his head, and now he is thinking, when I have fallen at his feet, I am sitting there like this, Kritanjali, with my hands folded. He will look at me. Sasmita, Mardraya Disha. Sasmitam, Ardraya Disha. That is, his face will have a very divine smile, looking at me, full of Karuna. And that smile will be moist with mercy and compassion. With that, all my sin, all my impurities will be simply washed off, and I will have eternal bliss in my heart. Vita Vishanka, I will not have any fear anymore. Because he has lifted me up, he has kept his hand on my head, and now he has looked at me with such smile, which is only giving me delight. I will not be fearful anymore. I will become full of delight, with everlasting delight. Suhrittamam jnatim ananya daivatam dorbhyam brihadbhyam parirapsyate thamam atmam hitirthikriyate tadaivame bandhascha karmatmaka uchvasityatah. I am his friend. I am his kinsman. I am his devotee. When seeing me fallen at his feet, he will look at me, and then what he will do? He will, with his powerful arms, the long arms, he will embrace me and he will look at me. When he embraces me, Atma hitirthi kriyate, my whole being will become holy and pure. I don't know whether you are able to imagine this, whether you are able to feel this. When I say, when I'm reading out, Atma hi tirthi kriyate, I think our whole being should become pure and holy. What has he done? What has Akrura got? He's only imagining. Till now he has not reached Vrindavana, but he is in the association of Lord Krishna. From the time he has started from his house till now, he is only thinking of Krishna. This will happen, that will happen, and he is in the association of that Supreme Lord. So from the time he has started from his house in that chariot, he is in association with Krishna. Through contemplation, through the thoughts, he has physically not reached Krishna, but he is having all the benefits of having that association. This is what we can do. We, the devotees, we always say that we don't have time. We always say that we don't have association. Through just thoughts, say, you are coming here, you are coming, having a lot of satsang, you have been listening to the lectures. The feelings that you have had, at some moments, you should preserve that. When you go home, maybe some days that will be you are feeling low, you may feel depressed, you may feel fearful. Think of those moments when you had felt that you have no fear, you have felt that your heart full of devotion. Think of those moments. So he says, Atma hi tirthi kriyate, and all the bandhas, all the bandhanas, the bondages that I have, all will be washed off. Suhittamam jnatim ananya daivatam dorbhyam brihadbhyam parirapsyate thamam atma hi tirthi kriyate tadaiva me bandhascha karmaatmaka uchvasityatah labdhanga sangam pranatam kritanjalim maam vakshyate krura tatetirushravah tadavayam janmabhrito mahiyasa naivadrito yo dhigamushya janmatat labdhanga sangam. What did he do? In his contemplation, he has been embraced by the Lord. He had fallen at his feet through contemplation. He had got the touch of the holy hands on his head through contemplation. Then when he fell, the Lord lifted him up, looked at him with smiling face. The smile is full of nectar, full of a fearlessness that the Lord is spreading. He has experienced all that. Then the Lord has embraced him. With the powerful long hands, the Lord lifted him up and embraced him. Labdhanga sangam. Just imagine that. That you have been embraced by the Lord and you are feeling the touch of his, that Holy One. We have to think like this. Labdhanga sangam pranatam kritanjalim. Now he hears in his mind the Lord is calling him. Oh Akrura, you have come. It is only in his thought. Lord has not yet come, but he is thinking that after embracing me, the Lord will say, oh Akrura, have you come? Tadavayam janmabhrito mahiyasa naivadrito yo dhigamushya janmatat. He says that when he calls me Akrura, I don't know what I will do. I think I will feel like crying aloud. All of you come and see how fortunate I am. The Lord has held me in embrace and he is calling me with my name. He doesn't know me. Still, he has accepted me. He has taken me in his embrace and he's calling me. He's asking me, oh Akrura, have you come? And at that time, my birth, having taken birth as a human being, will be fulfilled. I will have fulfillment in this world. Janma safal ho jayega mera. Jab mujhe Bhagwan aalingan karenge aur वो जो एक स्पर्श उनका हमको मिलेगा, हमें लगेगा कि हम पुकार के सबको बोलें कि सब आइए और देखिए कि हम कितने फॉर्चुनेट हैं, कितना हमारा सौभाग्य है कि भगवान ने मुझे आलिंगन कर लिया है और मुझे बुलाया है. और उस समय, उस क्षण में मुझे लगेगा कि मेरा जो ये जन्म है वो सफल है. डियर डिवोटीज, there is a purpose of this human birth. It is not purposeless. God has made us human beings with a purpose. To find him, to search him, to find him, to realize him. Nowhere else but here in our own heart. He is in our heart. We can find him. We can feel his presence, but we must want it. Always we are looking outside. Always we are attracted to worldly things which are perishable, which are short-lived. We think our happiness will come from there. We do not look inside us. There he is stretching his arms and he is sitting there waiting for us. Waiting and waiting and waiting. If only we look at him, he is ready to embrace us and give us that abode of fearlessness which all of us want. Labdhanga sangam pranatam kritanjalim maam vakshyate krura tatetyurushravah tadavayam janmabhrito mahiyasa naivadritoyo dhigamushya janmatat. Anybody, any human being who has not searched for the Lord, who has not found the Lord, who has not done anything to know who is He, what the one who enlivens us. This body is there, but something enlivens us. Some spirit is there, some soul is there. Everything that we do, whether we talk, we sit, we eat, we walk, everything, all our senses, our organs are enlivened by some power. We do not even think about it. The whole day goes, we never think of that. We never is grateful to that. We think when we do something good, we feel I have done. And when something goes wrong, we are always complaining to God. So he says, naivadrito yo dhigamushya janmatat. Those who are not spending their time in search of God, their janma is useless. Useless. I think all of us are very, very fortunate that at least there is a feeling, there is an yearning, there is a liking to listen to such good talks or about God, about Brahman, about the soul. We want to hear. And even if it is for a little while, it will be beneficial for the whole life. Natasya kaschid daita suhittamo na chapriyo dveshya upekshya eva va tathapi bhaktan bhajate yatha tatha suradrumo yad upashrito arthadaha. He is not particularly dear or friendly to anybody. Nobody is particularly priya to him. He does not have any enemy. He does consider anybody to be his friend or enemy. But still, he gives all the devotees, whoever worships him, all that they want. Everything that they ask for, he gives. But he waits for that day when the devotee will only want him and nothing else. They are the greatest bhaktas who want nothing else. They want only his holy feet. They want to merge into that holy feet. They do not want anything else. They say that, O Lord, when you fulfill our desire, people think that it is a blessing. But it is not a blessing, because when you fulfill our desire, for some time we are happy. Again, another desire comes to our mind. Again, we become excited. Again, we become agitated. Again, we become fearful whether this desire will be fulfilled or not. And the story only repeats. They do not understand that this is not the real blessing when desires are fulfilled by you. But those who do not want anything from you, O Lord, they say that we want nothing from you. We want only yourself. You give yourself to them and they become the most blissful people in this world. So this is what Akrura was thinking. Now he has come thinking like this. He must be thinking in a very absorbed manner. So though Mathura and Vrindavan are very quite near to each other, he has taken a long time to come because he must have got completely absorbed in his thoughts. So it became nearly dusk when he reached Vrindavana. Tomorrow we'll see when he sees Krishna, what he does. Ityachyutanghrim bhajato nuvrittya bhaktir viraktir bhagavat prabodhaha bhavanti vai bhagavatasya rajan tato param shantim upaiti sakshat ityachyutanghrim bhajato nuvrittya Bhaktir virattir bhagavat prabodha bhavanti vai bhagavatasya rajan tato param shantim upaiti sakshat. When we contemplate on the Lord, the felicity that we have, when we completely become one with the Lord, we do not want anything else, we think about Him to the exclusion of everything else, then what happens? Bhakti grows in us. Along with that virakti, dispassion also grows in us. That is, the little things which we were fond of, we find them meaningless. We find so much of devotion to the Lord that many of the things simply fall off in our lives. And slowly when the bhakti maturates, ripens, gets deepened, we have Bhagavat Prabodha, realization of the Lord in our heart. And when we have realization, Tato Param Shanti Mupaiti Sakshat, at that time we have Param Shanti, supreme peacefulness in our mind. I think all of us want that peacefulness. Ekopi Krishnasya Krita Pranamo Dashashvamedha Vabhritena Tulyaha Dashashvamedhi Punareti Janma Krishna Pranamena Punarbhavaya Krishna Vrata Krishna Manusmaranto Ratrau Cha Krishnam Punaruthitaye Te Krishna Deha Pravishanti Krishnam Ajyam Yatha Mantra Hutam Hutashe Krishna Vrata Krishna Manusmaranto Ratrau Cha Krishnam Punaruthitaye Te Krishna Deha Pravishanti Krishnam Ajyam Yatha Mantra Hutam Hutashe. Jai Guru, Jai Guru, Jai Guru.